三五年宣传或者公告未经批准集结，最高刑罚判监一年。而近期法庭在两宗公共活动的判决案里面呢，清楚显示了参与未经批准集结属于犯法，无论是涉及暴力与否，而有关的被告人等分别呢亦都被判处不同的监禁刑期的。在这里我再次提醒大家，不要以身试法，任何人尝试挑战法律，包括限聚令、公安条例、香港国安法等等，警方都会严肃依法处理。
Is that the same reason why Hong Kong is banning a June 4th vigil? Second question, according to reports, you have sent letters to bankers warning them they will face jail or fines for any dealings with Jimmy Lai's account. Why would they face such a punishment, and are they falling afoul of the national security law or other laws? And would this threat cause harm to Hong Kong's reputation as a financial center and cause an exodus of banking sector representatives?
The Commissioner of Police deals with the notice of public meeting and public gathering in accordance with the Public Order Ordinance of Hong Kong. He is the man to exercise the power. And in connection with the 30th of May and the June 4th public gatherings, the Commercial Police takes consideration of factors that is prevailing. That is our Hong Kong system, and our decision is made in accordance with the Hong Kong law. As regards my written notice to companies and institutions regarding property which are offenses related property under the national security law, I am exercising the power because Lai has been charged with two offenses of collusion with other countries or external forces to endanger national security. It is my duty to specify in my notice to the relevant parties what will be the consequences if they fail to comply with my direction. The purpose of my notice is targeted at the property, targeted at the offences related property in relation to offences endangering national security. Normal businesses have nothing to do with any act that may endanger national security. So we should not associate the two matters in any way. Normal businessmen will go about their duties and have nothing to do with endangering national security, and we should not associate the two matters.
So
警方回覆的封信就是限聚你遊，那現在究竟說結束一黨專政是否違反國安法呢？另外想問整個案件，就看到你去信了，即有報道就說你去信了匯豐銀行和花旗銀行，這些行為會不會影響香港的信譽呢？
警務處處長去決定對某一些公眾活動的舉辦是否法出一個反對呢？他是按照公安條例所賦予的權力去考慮的，他亦都按住實際情況 去作出決定嘅。當警務處處長作出咗決定反對之後，有關嘅活動咧就係一個未經批准嘅集結嘅。而喺未經批准嘅集結嘅情況之下，任何人參與都係違法。而參與呢一啲未經批准嘅集結，最高咧係可以判監禁五年嘅。而喺呢度咧，我亦都再次聲明，任何嘗試挑戰法律，無論係限聚令，無論係公安條例，無論係香港國安法，我哋都會依法嚴肅處理嘅。我唔喺呢度咧去討論某一啲行為咧會唔會違反某一個法律，但係根據我哋香港嘅國安法裏邊去清晰講明咧，任何人如果組織、策劃、實施用非法手段去破壞或者推翻喺中國憲法之下所定嘅根本制度，是屬於顛覆國家政權罪。每個人都要向自己的行為負責，如果是涉及違法的行為，尤其是涉及香港國安法的，我們是會嚴肅地根據法律處理它的。至於我發出書面通知去凍結黎智英所擁有的股票以及佢一啲公司喺銀行嘅財產，我考慮嘅係因為黎智英已經被起訴兩宗危害國家安全、勾結外國或者外部勢力危害國家安全嘅罪行。我喺充分考慮咗我掌握嘅材料之後，我有理由懷疑有關嘅資產是相關罪行的財產，所以我運用香港國安法所賦予的權力去凍結有關的財產。我所針對的是危害國家安全的罪行，和我們正常去營商的任何行為扯不上關係。我亦都相信正常行商或者經營事業的人士是不會做出危害國家安全的任何行為的，所以不應該將兩件事情扯埋嚟到講嘅。
澳門明哥話咧，幾重嘅擋箭牌啊？
咁其實喺呢個情況底下，
其實
銀行係咪都已經冇咗自己嘅決定，佢即係維護者客户嘅利益咧？同埋即係依家如果咁樣講到，係咪即係銀行本身自己都要負埋個刑責咧？另外六四咧，嗰度都想問問啦，其實喺國安法下，其實即係依家市民都冇呢個自由自己去悼念呢個六四啦，係咪冇咗呢個自由咧？同埋如果佢哋自己自行去高叫一啲口號，譬如結束香港專政嘅呢一啲關於六四集會嘅呢啲口號啦，其實佢哋有冇話違反任何嘅港區國安法咧？
首先，我發出的書面通知去凍結的資產咧，係啲犯罪的資產，同危害國家安全罪行相關的資產。呢啲咧同我哋講一般人士佢自己嘅財產係兩碼子嘅事，呢個係要清晰講清楚嘅。犯罪嘅財產係會依法處理嘅。另外，任何人佢去做任何事情、參與任何活動，他必須守法。現在警務處處長考慮了所有因素，包括限聚令、包括公共安全、公共秩序等等的因素，他發出了反對的通知書。這個就是未經批准的集結，任何人參與未經批准的集結就是違法，而任何人去做任何的行為，如果是挑戰我們任何的法律，我們都會依法處理，包括我們香港的國安法。好，多謝你們。